Hey, this is Lee Barnett, and I want to introduce the project I'll be doing this semester. It's on the benefits of prior learning assessments to disadvantaged adults. Now, specifically, we want to talk about what prior learning assessments are and to give a definition of those. And basically, it's the idea of getting credit for non-academic training that an adult has received in the workplace, often in the military, those types of things. So we see it a lot in the high school students coming into college where they use advanced placement classes or they CLEP out of classes. Well, for adults, it has to do with going back and evaluating, was this training at work, this professional instruction, does it line up with what we do in an academic setting to a point that they could receive credit? And colleges have a lot of different uses and variations of these. A lot go through the American Council on Education to have those assessed and accredited so they know they're getting quality stuff. A lot of colleges want to do it in-house. There's a lot of ways to go about doing that, and a lot of colleges just strictly don't use PLAs at all. They do not allow for any type of credit from non-academic training. But for the adult student, there's a lot of benefit. First, it cuts down on time to graduation. It makes you feel like you've gotten a short game win in that, and it also cuts the cost of college by knocking out some classes that had to be taken. Now, as we pull this in a little bit tighter for the topic of this course with disadvantaged adults, those things come even more into play. An adult who struggled with being able to go to college the first time, a lot of times it is a learning issue, sometimes it's a socioeconomic issue. There's a lot of reasons that an adult either did not go to college or dropped out of college the first time, and those come into play. So for a student who has learning disabilities as an adult, this could be an opportunity for them to get credit by participating in training that fits within their area of intelligence. And we'll refer back to multiple intelligences for that. But if you have a student that maybe struggles in the classroom with academic work, but they're great mechanically, is there a place that they can get credit for mechanical training? If they struggle with writing, but they're good with numbers, is there a place that some of their training, especially if they work maybe in a banking industry, can come into play? We already do this with a lot of military students. Giving them credit for the training. So there's got to be a place in here that we can do it for adults as well. Again, another aspect of this is the fact that a lot of disadvantaged adults, especially with socioeconomic issues, they're not making a lot of money if they haven't been to college. And if they're struggling to have a job and they're struggling with their learning issues, that challenge increases that much more. So to accelerate the time to graduation for them is a big deal. That's that much less tuition they have to pay. Plus, it's that much quicker that they can get to a better job. And I'll go back again, and we'll talk about this some more in the longer version of this, is there's an emotional piece to this. There's a place in there for an adult when they can say, I have a win. When they can come into a program and say, okay, it's going to take me 120 hours to graduate, but this school just gave me 20 hours for my training of things that I've already learned that I'm good at. That is a step up. That is a motivating factor for an adult that will help them kind of engage and be ready to go forward and not feel like they're starting from ground zero. So as we explore these, we'll look at these areas. What are the benefits to adults as a whole? What are the benefits to disadvantaged adults? And then we'll talk about how we can put these things into play to make for a better opportunity for our students.